Hello everyone, my name is Iretiola and you're watching Oge, the place where we celebrate the best that Africa has to offer. Now on today's edition, we shall be profiling two individuals that are at the forefront of Nigerian show business. They both wear multiple hats. They're both award-winning producers, actors. No, they're not directors. But hey, it promises to be a very exciting edition, so we'll see you after the break. Welcome back. Now, our first profile is on a young, brilliant Nigerian woman. She's an actor, producer, singer, dancer, public speaker, influencer, among several things. And guess what? She does each and every one extremely well. Presented with the 2016 AMVCA Trailblazer Award, she's gone on to do bigger and better things. So sit back and relax as we bring you up close and personal with Kemi Lala Akindoju.
My name is Kemi Lala Akindoju, popularly called Lala. I'm an actor and a producer. So I didn't always want to be an actor. I knew that I loved standing in front of people, talking, singing, dancing. Just put me on a stage and allow me to express myself and I'm at home. But you know, you always need to fine tune these things, know exactly what you want to do. I was in my second year when I was offered my first professional work as an actor. A young man called Yinka Odunfa was producing a play called All I Want for Christmas in December of 2005. And that was my first professional job and I loved it. Loved it. Like, I was so at home on that stage. And I was like, I want to do this forever. Working on stage strictly for 5 years was deliberate. It was deliberate because I felt like I wasn't professionally trained as an actor and a performer. And because I believe in process. And so I told myself and I thought to myself that I could send myself to university by working on stage. That would allow me experience what it means to be a whole, you know, a wholesome actor, if I may use that word. And I would understand the different departments in the industry, from costuming to set, you know. And, you know, I knew that working on stage required, you know, killing yourself, you know, killing your ego and just becoming. That was the foundation I wanted to give my career for a certain level of projection. The people I had written down to be my mentors, some of which I would mention. I hadn't met any of them, so it was all in my head and in my room. Taiwa Jaila, I said, Joke Silva, Iretiola Doyle, Kate Henshaw, all started on stage, or all had really strong presence on stage. They could, you know, they had functioned on all the platforms. So I'm like, if I'm going to be like these women, I'm going to have to, you know, work on stage. And I wanted to get their attention, those women in particular. So it was deliberate.
In 1 week, Auntie Laura have buy me new clothes, she buy me new shoe, and then she buy me a portmanteau. I now start to tell my friends that I begin to speak PP grammar like others when you go people. You know, like, pass me the curvy. The guy is very handsome. I'm going to Hovers. I was excited.
I think from my mother's womb, I was an expressive child. Anyway, you know, the kind of child that asked questions about everything. You know, I would ask my mom, okay, mommy, why is your hair like that? And she'll tell me, my hair is like that because it's brown. Why is it brown? It's brown because that's the color of the hair. Well, why is it, you know? And then at some point you want to beat the child. That's the kind of child I was. But my mother didn't beat me. She endured it. And I remember, I don't know how old I was, but I was younger than 8 years old. I had an uncle, Uncle Sunday, in fact. He would say, you know, you ask so many questions. And then when anybody asks you why you ask so many questions, tell them, I have an inquiring mind and it must be nurtured. I didn't know what that sentence meant, but it sounded really good. So everywhere I went as a child, and this is a true life story, when I start asking you questions and I can sense that you're getting me, I'll say, won't you ask me why I ask so many questions? And then the adult will be like, okay, why do you ask so many questions? And then I'll say, because I have an inquiring mind and it must be nurtured. I didn't know the meaning of that sentence until much later in my life. The truth is, as an adult who's wiser, there's some minuses to this trait of mine. And it takes the people who know me and genuinely love me to know that, first of all, I mean no harm, I mean no disrespect, and then I'm learning. I'd like to say I'm more in control of it now. The times when I insist on expressing is I refuse to be taken for granted. I refuse for people to be taken for granted. And so it's been a minus, I must say, but I'm learning to turn it into a strength. As much as I may appear to have it all together, when it comes to my work and my craft, confidence, I do not assume that I have it all together. So I feel like I must pass certain litmus tests before moving forward. In 2010, February, I won the Future Awards Actor of the Year. That award, I don't even know if the Future Awards people know this, that award gave me the confidence to know that I'm ready or I'm doing something right. And then I could go for more auditions for work in front of the camera.
Ah, good morning, ma.
No great meal.
Sorry, ma.
Don't sorry me.
I realized that certain people will get a certain level of attention because of how they looked, how they dressed, and you know, the general noise or you know, noise they made or how they packaged themselves. And I would say I'm a pure artist. I'm all about the art. No, it's not necessary. But there is a point you get to when you want more. And you have to admit it. There's no need. The challenge I find with pure artists is sometimes the art, they're so proud in the art that they do not admit that they want more. And that more might be a little more recognition. That more might be a little more attention. It might be a little more money. And it's not bad because guess what? You're an artist and you're probably extremely talented. So that attention, you deserve it. I'm not advocating for stepping away from who you are. I'm saying when you have content, you have to package the outward so that the thing inside will be noticed because we need to see that thing inside, but something must attract it. So I'm very passionate about talented people packaging themselves, getting on social media, making the right noise because those are the people that should make the noise. Deciding or choosing to play the role I played in 50 was very deliberate. I have decided to be a part of every great thing around me. And if I have to stoop to conquer, I will. For me, the bigger picture is king. The company in whom I'm seen matters first. And so the cast of that film, it's okay for me to be called amongst them, number one. Number two, an opportunity to be around the making of something that will be great. It's a learning process for me. The things I learned being on that set, I was on the set for, 3 days, 4 days max. The things that I learned, my colleagues wish they learned it. Because I know the details, I can say firsthand how that beautiful film was made. But if I wasn't in that film as an actor, I may not have had that access.
Tell me, Daddy, why?
Well, because we love you.
Knowing the pain and misery I will go through in my life, yet you claim you love me.
Take what your father said. It is because we love you.
All this physical and mental torture. Eh? Why did you give me this life of agony, Mommy? Why?
I'm not that actor. I'm not that performer who puts herself before the art. We will weigh the pros and cons. And if on the artistic side, there are more pros, I'm going to do it. My advice to anyone who wants to grow in the industry will be, first of all, don't work for money. Never think of money. Secondly, stoop to conquer. Remove yourself. And the truth is, as a true actor or artist, yourself must die. Because if yourself is intact, you cannot fully become these different characters you would have to play. So when you make it a habit to put your ego under control, you will find out that the art and the artist in you will rise. And the cause, which is to tell the stories, to shine, every artist wants to shine, will come to the fore. And somehow, the directors, the filmmakers, the producers, the decision makers, they will see into the core of your art spirit and they will be drawn to you. every time. And I'd like to say, you know, go through the process. Go through the process. Go through it. You know, respect people. Respect people that have paid their dues. When you don't know, admit that you don't know. You know, learn. We don't stop learning until we die. So learn. Be humble. As in, be humble, Sha. Be humble. And so deciding to produce with the biggest names in the industry is also deliberate. Because I remember my first big production, The V-Monologues. I said, nobody knows me as an actor. Sorry, nobody knows me as a producer. They're going to wonder, why is this girl producing? But when they see the people that are going to perform, they'll look a second time. And so that was me deliberately standing on the shoulders of my egbons and my senior colleagues. And I love challenges. And working with these people, for me, it's a challenge. And we can do it. And, you know, I go for it. Plus, if it's not going to be great for me, there's no need. There's absolutely, if it is not going to be great, let's not bother. The 2016 AMVCA Trailblazer is going to continue working hard. So expect to hear more things from her. My mouth. Visible panty lines, nip slips, like when the cleavage is, you know, when the nipple shows. All the fashion flops of old, they are now cool. Stripe on stripe is cool. Pattern on pattern is cool. Denim on denim is cool. Ugh. Panty line gives me headache though. Style for me is comfortable, elegant, chic. In my opinion, the contemporary Nigerian woman can do more. In my opinion, the contemporary Nigerian woman needs to step up. She needs to stop singing songs of pity. The opportunities are there. The question I ask is, where are the women? You know, the opportunities are there. The men are waiting. And so enough of the, I'm a woman, stop it. You, contemporary Nigerian woman, you have all you need. Go for it and do it. I have two philosophies of life. One, there is no such thing as it can't be done. Sit down, sit still, 2 hours, a solution will come to you. Second philosophy of life, don't wait until the metal is hot to strike. Keep striking until it gets hot.
Since granting us this interview, Lala has gone on to produce her own one-woman theatre production that received critical acclaim. We look forward to seeing what next she'll come up with. Okay, we're going to go on a short break, and when we come back, we'll continue with the rest of our show. Welcome back. Now, our next profile is on an individual that began his career as a comedian. And since then, he's continued to grow in leaps and bounds and is not showing any signs of slowing down. He's gone on to become a producer extraordinaire, producing some of Nigeria's most successful motion pictures of all time. What exactly makes AY tick? We're about to give you some deeper insight.
I see. Everybody talking about subsidy. Everybody talking all about subsidy. On to the next one. I see.
My name is Richard Ayodeji. Oluwagboyi Babamiga Makun. Don't bother. Just call me AY. How do I describe myself? AY is an all-encompassing showbiz personality. You can see me as a comedian. You can see me as an actor, you can see me as a producer, but just call me an entertainer. When I was in the university in 1998, I started a campus beauty pageant, and known as Delso, most beautiful girl on campus. Before then, I was working with NIPC Junior Staff Club, where I doubled as an organizer and a personal assistant to somebody who was packaging shows at the time. And I gained inroad proper when I came to Lagos and I started working with the king of comedy, Ali Baba, as his personal assistant. And that was where I thought it right to take it to another level. And we are today. It's very, very important for you to understand somebody. It's very important for you to have a mentor. It's very important for you to look at somebody and say, this is what this person is doing, and this is the path I want to follow. And for Ali Baba, it was even much more important because at the time, he was the biggest. It was everything you could think about when it comes to comedy. Even now as we speak, he's still the king of comedy. So having the privilege to understudy him, having the privilege to work with him as his personal assistant, and later becoming his event manager, made a lot of sense, added value to my own brand. And as you can see, if you look at the level of professionalism, the way I carry out my work, my duty as a stand-up comedian, as an entertainer, you know that this is somebody who actually, understudied not just the king of comedy, but understanding what it means to have a mentor.
No! I'm a prophet. This cannot happen. I'm a prophet. Is that room service? Please give me two. Room service. And two Odeku. And four energy drinks, please. Hurry up.
Sakuya! Not Sakuya, energy drinks.
I always tell people that when you are inspired, you aspire to want to do something. And for me, it comes with a lot of research. It comes with a lot of understudy, understanding somebody that is in the business at any given time, understudying that person, know what the person is doing right, looking at the strategies that they have, looking at the application of such strategies, and also trying to come in with your own tonic, also trying to come in with your own vibe. It's not a stroke of luck, but I can as well tell anybody who cares to listen that I'm a product of grace. A lot of people don't even have the slightest idea that I studied for it. I'm a theater art graduate. I majored in directing. Apart from that, I've always wanted to be an actor. I used to see RMD on screen and be like, I like this bro. Someday I want to be like him. And I eventually met him in Warri back in the day. And it was one of the people who also encouraged me and said, well, if it's something you want to do, find time, You know, it's not just about seeing us on TV. You need to understand the point where you're getting it right, and you need to understand the point where people are beginning to appreciate what you're doing. And then the business side comes in. Now you can now make money. The business side is very, very important right now, because I've been able to build the brand, and it's now time for me to start making money from building the brand to the point where people would appreciate the brand, would patronize the brand, would understand the brand, and want to do business with the brand.
Can't you see the private jet?
Yes.
That's my father. He doesn't like me moving with governor's daughters.
Hey, why? Your father is...
He will hear you.
Ah! You're a liar. Your father can see you from private jet, from airport to this place.
Oh, so your father can see from mast.
Some people, they lie for this world.
Oh, you're not a liar.
Oh,
my brother,
Setting up the nightclub is part of me being an entrepreneur, and at the same time, is a social ground. It's a place where I fraternize with industry people, and also make that provision available for them to come and relax and do whatever they need to do as well. This is just the beginning for AY. What I've been doing is trying to discover myself, trying to have an understanding of what works for me as an entertainer, what works for me as an entrepreneur, what works for me as a businessman generally. Now I think I have a basic understanding of what it is. We're just crashing the surface right now. We're about to go into the business of entertainment big time, and the show starts now. I think one of the major mistakes that entertainers make is some of them, they make money and they don't get to invest. And you know, you can't be there forever. Everybody has got their time within a given time and space. So a lot of entertainers do not understand that, and they tend to make a major mistake by not investing, and you see them fall back to level zero. And another mistake is a lot of them, they see themselves as demigods, especially when they are there, in quotes. Everybody becomes zero. And there is a natural law that goes against people like that, because the people you look down on, the people you play down on because you're there, are the same people you're coming to meet, especially when that 8-track is not there, when your movie is not selling. And then you give them room to pay back. And you give them room not to accept you as one of them, because they always would remember what you did to them at any point in time. So I think issue of pride is another thing. There are a lot of people, they are larger than life. They don't even know how to keep relationship with even fellow entertainers. And I think all of these mistakes put together diminish your brand and puts you in a place where it's difficult to just bounce back.
Don't leave my wife alone. This one that the two of you are where, Uncle, are you going to Bajini? I don't want to have anything to do with you. Leave my wife alone. Where's wife? Leave my wife alone. You're not ashamed of yourself, useless man. It doesn't seem to know you. I agree with you. Yes, I agree with you that I don't even know her, yes? But I want to know her. This is the kind of woman I want to know in my life. I do not want to know anything about you. Leave this woman alone before I unleash my anger. Unleash what? Unleash! Anyone that can unleash? Me too, I will unleash my vest on you. In fact, I want to unleash now. Bebe. I want to unleash now. Sebi, you want to unleash?
Bebe.
Sebi, you want to unleash?
Bebe.
Come on, this. When I finish unleashing on you, I will unleash on her too.
You're lucky that I haven't eaten. You are very, very lucky.
Wait, let me cook for you.
Networking is key in any given business. You don't even have to be an entertainer. Networking makes it easy for you to run your business. There are a lot of people who tend to be in business and they would work and work and work and work and work, and at the end of the day, they are not getting results. But when you build a network, or when you find yourself in the space of networking with the people that you do your business with, or the people that you supply or dedicate your business to, it helps you to go to another level. I think the Nigerian youth is they're kind of laid back. We hardly want to do research. You just look at a particular direction, and then the next thing, they think that somebody is making money from something, and they just want to get into it. It doesn't work that way. I am going to organize a forum where those who look at AY and say, I want to be like AY, I would want to let them on this, I would want to give them that inroad into understanding where AY started from to the point that it is right now. I would never believe that I want to go back to where I'm coming from. I would never believe that poverty is something that is going to affect me and my generation. It's something I will never take, because it's very, very important that I would never go back to where I'm coming from. Yeah, style. Style is important. I mean, for me, style is not just being yourself, creating an identity that people can identify with. And that is what it is for me. Three things that can stop anybody from is connecting yourself with people who have that negative vibe. They are not your friends. You must learn to take risk. You must learn to also understand what you're doing. Life is about giving. It's about showing love. And the more you give, the more you receive.
Wow. You have to admire AY's strength, tenacity, and can-do spirit. Well, here's wishing the man many, many more successes. We've come to the end of our show, but please don't forget to hit us up on Instagram, Twitter, Facebook. Let us know what you think, and we'd be more than willing to respond to you. Now, until I come your way with another exciting edition of the show, I'm asking you to look after yourselves and be kind to one another. Goodbye.